The size of the industry is about $1.8 billion US annually. So it's a very small industry. It's what we call a niche industry. If you think about where some of you might be working one day in the oil industry or automotive or health or wherever, you're talking about a multi-billion dollar industry, maybe half a billion or maybe 500 million, a billion. So we're talking, you know, could be up to trillions of dollars. We're talking about a very small segment here. iStock Photo and Getty Images really combined to create the largest visual content supplier in the world. Getty was the leader as far as revenues go. iStock Photo was questionably the leader, although there's no sure way to tell. But iStock Photo was probably the leader when it comes to the amount of images sold. So the pure volume of images downloaded every single year. So you combine those two and we're unquestionably the largest visual content supplier in the world. Our company was founded in 2000 by Bruce Livingston. And Bruce was really a man of many talents. He was a photographer, he was a designer, he was a drummer in a rock and roll band. Bruce and I in the early 90s had worked for Adobe Systems. And he had this idea where he would just do what everybody else was doing, which was to take a few thousand images, put them on CD-ROMs, and start marketing them. Well, that really didn't turn out into anything because the friction in taking CDs to market was really quite prohibitive. All the marketing costs and all the sales costs and distribution costs. He conceived a community site where he would just give away images. And it ended up becoming what I call the bake sale of stock photography. So he had his 2,000 images free on the site, and he said, hey, photographers, if you want some of my images, I'd like you to bring in some of your images and share with the rest of the community. And for every image that you put on the site for everyone to share with, I'll give you the rights to download 5 of mine and use 5 of mine, right? So this really encouraged people to just start uploading their own images and start sharing with the community. So like I say, it started with 2,000 of Bruce's free images. And today, we have over 20,000 photographers that really just bought into the concept. At some point in time, we started charging some money for it so that everybody could play, so that not just photographers, but designers who didn't have images, but who had, you know, a few quarters could come in and buy some images. We garner over 6 million page views per day. And this presentation was done about 3 weeks ago, and I suspect that that's slightly out of date. We might be just crawling up just a little bit more. When you're charging 25 cents or 50 cents or a dollar per image, the most important thing is to take away all the friction involved with the transaction costs. So if we were to charge you a dollar for a photo, and we were to take your credit card for that dollar, we would get charged a service fee plus a percentage, and so that might turn out to be 20% transaction cost for that transaction. Well, what we asked our customers to do is to buy image credits, and so they would buy 10 image credits or 40 image credits at a time. That way, we could charge 10 or 25 or $50 at a time. A lot of applications out there won't credit people for their sales until after it's gone through maybe a 1 hour or 24-hour period, just to check for fraud or to check for other security measures. Well, we don't do that. We basically give people their money right away. So that if you're a photographer and somebody's downloaded your image a second ago, you will see a half second later, or maybe even sooner, the royalties dumped right into your account. A lot of our photographers were pulling up browser windows at work because they were doing this part-time and refreshing their screen every 5 minutes just to see how many images they had sold in the last 5 minutes. This is real time, right? And in fact, some of our photographers had gone so far and had become so addicted to seeing how many nickels or how many dimes they had made that they had built their own application, their little watcher window in the bottom right-hand corner of their menu bar, just that basically pulls down a live feed. And so every time they sold something, it would show up. And so again, absolutely amazing what the community will react to. But what about people just browsing the site? Well, you'll see here that you see exactly how many images have been sold, or how,
of any particular image. So for instance, in this file number, you'll see that 513 downloads of that image. That image has been sold 513 times, and that it's been viewed 3,499 times. Right? And there's ratings and who the image belongs to. And so for any consumer, they can look at this and say, you know what, I don't want an image that's been sold 513 times. I'd rather have something that's only been sold twice. We came across a lot of skepticism in our early days, and people looked at the model and said, well, how much money can you actually make at doing this, selling images at a dollar? Why would I want to sell my images and collect a commission off an image that's being sold for a dollar when traditional images are being sold for $100 or maybe even thousands of dollars? Well, we needed a way to show photographers exactly how much money was being made. So here it is. You know, this is one of our top photographers in Quebec. Her name is Lise Gagné. And this screen grab was pulled about a month ago. And you'll see that she sold 302,582 images in the stretch of about, I would say, 2 years, maybe even less. And so all these statistics are immediately available on the site today. So if you went to the site and you looked at any photographer, you can see that there's photographers that sold only 7 or 8 images, like me. And there's other photographers like Lise that have sold hundreds of thousands of images. Our customers come from all over the place today. We're especially popular in the editorial fields where they don't have huge budgets to spend on photography. So you'll see Oprah and Wired magazine and a lot of the news websites like ABC.com in Australia using iStock photo images. Really big in the SOHO, small office, home office, and the small medium business segment.
You can go back all the way to the beginning of the website, which the first version was written in Cold Fusion and used an Access database. So this would be 2001. We committed to going to an open source lab environment. In the beginning, we were running on 2 servers that somebody probably built in their basement from scrap hardware. In terms of technology or running a site like iStock Photo, there's 2 key components: disaster recovery and high availability. You know, everybody knows time is money, so Pat'll tell you downtime is money too, right? So if we go down for 5 minutes, we're losing money. Right now, we have a really good relationship with IBM. We scrapped those 2 junky pieces of hardware, and we run everything on IBM hardware, including servers and our disk subsystems. Big projects that we just completed about 3-4 months ago was introducing a storage area network that was based on IBM's general purpose file system, which is a really highly scalable, highly redundant environment, and it's been working great for us. So as Pat mentioned, we get between 10 and 12,000 new images every week. Those images have to be stored somewhere. They have to be available in real time to be downloaded. So that's a huge part of our hosting environment. We handle the redundancy and scalability through clustering. 2 clusters, the web server clusters, which is currently a suite of 12 PHP Apache machines. And they're all fiber channel and 2 connections to the GPFS. And the other cluster is the database cluster, which we run MySQL. They provide a couple of ways of doing clustering, but the main way is through a master-slave architecture. So all writes and updates go to the master, transaction, that kind of stuff, and then reads can go to any number of slaves that replicate from the master. So we have 1 master and currently 4 slaves, but we can scale it up or down at any time, depending on volume. And we always have one of the slaves that can be promoted to the master position if something happens to the master. And we've never done it on the live site, but in testing it takes about 30 seconds to recover from a failure of the master. And then we have 1 database server that just handles session information. We retrieve data from the database server once and then put it in our memory-based cache so that we can read it over and over again really quickly, because memory is so much faster. To deal with volume issues, we use a service called Akamai. And what Akamai provides is a network of globally distributed proxy servers. So again, it's reducing the load on our infrastructure by caching static content. 2.5 years ago, which is just when I started with iStock Photo, there was one person in